Today I had the pleasure to meet Mr. Kvirikashvili for the first time in his capacity as Prime Minister of Georgia. Let me again welcome you here, Georgi, and congratulate you on your appointment. The European Union and Georgia are true partners. As the association agreement enters fully into force, we'll be able to cooperate even more comprehensively in implementing Georgia's political association and economic integration with the EU. Today, we discussed a broad range of issues. We talked about the upcoming parliamentary elections in Georgia. And we agree that a free and pluralistic media environment and an open and vibrant political environment are prerequisites for success. Continued reforms of the judiciary, rule of law, and human rights are important priorities, and I underlined the EU's readiness to assist. It is crucial that criminal investigations and prosecutions be evidence-based, transparent, and impartial, in line with the commitment of the association agreement. We also discussed at length the issue of visa-free travel for Georgian citizens. Let me congratulate Georgia on the outstanding reforms undertaken in this process. Georgia has fulfilled all the benchmarks of the Visa Liberalization Action Plan. It is now for the Council and the European Parliament to bring this process to a successful conclusion. The European Union will continue to give its firm support for the territorial integrity of Georgia within its internationally recognized borders. I share Georgia's concerns about the continued implementation of the so-called treaties between Russia and Abkhazia and South Ossetia. I saw for myself the situation at the administrative boundary line, including the borderization process during my last visit to Georgia. I also expressed our strong appreciation for Georgia's important contribution to EU crisis management operations and missions, including to our missions and operations in the Central African Republic, Ukraine, and Mali. Finally, let me add a comment on Russia, whose actions in Syria are making an already very bad situation even worse. As a direct consequence of the Russian military campaign, the murderous Assad regime is gaining ground, the moderate Syrian opposition is losing ground, and thousands more refugees are fleeing towards Turkey and Europe. Thank you for your coming here again. Georgi, dear friend, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Donald, President Tusk. This is a great honor to be here, and I would like to extend our sincere gratitude towards EU's longstanding support for Georgia's European agenda, and including your personal support to this end. We value the unique relationship that we have developed with the EU through the political association and economic integration. Let me reiterate our firm commitment to activate the full potential of this relationship. With the extensive assistance and support from the EU, we have been steadily progressing on the democratic reform agenda. And we had a discussion with President Tusk of the importance of ensuring highest standards of democracy during the election year, including the importance of the judicial reform and continuing of the judicial reform and providing the free media space for all stakeholders in the election process, including also the engaging of the civil society and NGOs in this process. The Visa Liberalization Action Plan has definitely served to accelerate the reform process in Georgia. As the technical requirements have been fully met, we hope that the visa-free regime will be shortly introduced for the citizens of Georgia. Indeed, these achievements will be a strong demonstration for Georgia and other partners that the European choice delivers concrete results. We are committed to achieving further accomplishments, and in this respect, effective implementation of the association agreement is our top priority. We look forward to start working on the new association agenda soon. Security and stability, as it was mentioned by President Tusk, are key prerequisites for the success of our common endeavors. Georgia still faces challenges and grave humanitarian consequences of occupation and creeping annexation of its territories by Russia. In this respect, we highly value the EU's unwavering support for Georgia's territorial integrity within its internationally recognized borders. During the meeting, we have exchanged views on the EU's stronger engagement in Georgia through the EUMM and effective non-recognition policy, confidence building, and active mediation for the EU Special Representative in the Geneva International discussions. Let me conclude by highlighting our ambition to make Georgia a success story of the European integration in the region. In this respect, we share the common commitment to the Eastern Partnership as a concrete policy framework to make our vision a reality. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.